gossip. Blah, blah, blah.
Hello, you all. It's me, Destiny of Manifest by Destiny. As you can see, I have one of the cups that I found on one of my Halloween 2021 adventures. But today we are out in the rain. It's Tuesday morning. We went on Monday afternoon to Rock Hill. Today's Tuesday morning and we're in Monroe. So the first stop is Marshall's. I'm in a parking lot where there's a Marshall's and Ollie's and a Hobby Lobby, as we know from last week's adventures. I should do a flashback. Oh my God, y'all, I was ranting for like 5 minutes. I wasn't recording. I went to Hobby Lobby, didn't get nothing because they don't have Halloween. This is a very religious based store. I know this because I tried to work here like 10 years ago and I didn't remember all this until I'm walking around. I'm like, where's the black and orange stuff? They don't have it. Yeah, but we went to Hobby Lobby and they declared that they will no longer carry Halloween decor as of 2021. Which is crazy because this is when I just like really got into buying it because I get to decorate my own space. So, yeah, I'm going to go into Marshall's. It's raining. I have my handy dandy raincoat, rain jacket. And I'm going to try not to go to Pike's because I know Pike's is right down the road. But I just went to Pike's like 2 weeks ago for my boyfriend's mom's birthday present. And I ended up buying myself like 3 plants. So, I'm going to not do that. I'm not going to go to any of the like big box stores, Home Depot, Lowe's. I'm not gonna go to Pike's, which is like a local nursery in North Carolina and in Georgia. But yeah, I linked all of the dupes to the Halloween decor finds that I have accumulated so far under this video in the description box. I found this Sit by Swell Hogwarts Houses Club. I found this, but it's not the tall one. It's like the one that's like this, so it's wider. Probably the same. I think this is like 15 ounces. But I like this cup. It definitely keeps your water nice and cold. I decided just to only put water in it. No key lime juice, no lemon juice, no cranberry juice, like mixed in with my water because I do that in the morning to get the people going. So I decided not to do that in here so this can stay as pure as possible. Yeah, it's 9:51. I like to get to places at 9 o'clock, but today I was lollygagging. I was bottom watering my plants and making reels. Insert my Instagram over here. So yeah, follow me on Instagram. I'm kind of upset though. This is okay, I'm gonna go inside the store at 10 o'clock. I just wanna disclose this. Personal disclosure, venting, session, rant. Instagram took away my music and I love music. Like, I don't know. I know everybody loves music, but I can't explain how much I love music. Like, I love music. I think I need lip gloss. But yeah, I love music and they took it away. Like 2 weeks ago, they were like, you will only have access to because of the type of account you have, I believe that's what they say. I don't know. I'm pretty sure I screenshotted. Juvia's Place Guava lip balm, lip gloss, lip balm. Yeah. The Nubian Glow lip balm in guava. Must have. I want to go back and get the one in grape. Back to what I was saying. They took away my access to copyrighted music. So now I'm only with 9,000 songs in copyrighted, the copyrighted library. So I'm trying to find ways to use like original audio. It's funny, I still have the access to saved, like a couple of saved songs. And my boyfriend's like, I think it might be his first Spanish song or one of his first Spanish songs that he put out. I made a reel to it, or either I saved his audio. So that's about to be my real music forever. I just turn it down. Having background, you know, because I feel personally attacked. I don't know if that means I should just go back to personal account, to a business, like because I'm a creator account, but I've never monetized my Instagram. I've never got paid for anything like that, so I don't know. I don't know if it's a personal attack or what, but it's funny. Yesterday, Instagram was acting up and everybody was like, oh, they're out to get me. And I was like, it's because we're creators. But no, Instagram was just down for everybody. So yeah, I'm going to go inside now. Hopefully I can find a bathroom because, yeah, look at the sky. I got my bag that everybody loves on Instagram that I got when I went thrifting in New Orleans. Still have that New Orleans thrift haul, or just haul in general, that I'm editing. Do y'all remember when you were kids and you used to put your jacket down and like have to flip it over to put it on? That's so cute. The more I sit here, the more I gotta use the bathroom. Yo, this guy looks crazy. I'm happy I got out. I know this is loud. I'm happy I got out the house though, because if I wouldn't have got out when I did, I would have been in there all day. And it's just crazy how many people are like shopping during the daytime. But it is summertime. Well, I think school starts like next week or something. I don't know. But I'm gonna... I think the last time I wore this was in New Orleans. There we go. Oh yeah, and I've been cramping, I think, so I can't believe that I'm having this strength to push through cramps, because it hits me hard. So we'll see what's in Marshall's, and I'll talk to y'all on my way out of there, or maybe after just a couple of stores. Stay tuned. I spent way too much time in Marshalls and I basically spent my whole budget. Let me see. I could still go to one store. I need to go to like a cheaper store. But they had the Ray Dunn bathroom collection inserted here. And I just couldn't help myself because, as you know, inside of my like plant room, witch room, whatever, it's more dark themed. Ooh, it's hot. In my bathroom, y'all haven't seen it yet. But of course, I'm gonna do like a decor. I have this giant thing on my face, elephant in the room. It is what it is. Like I said, I'm cramping, so that's what happens. Welcome to my life, or the life of a woman. Well, or the life of a person who menstruates, let me say that. Because I've been watching, you know, I can't get into that. But anyway, I'm not going there. I'm not getting all controversial and not getting paid. No. But what was I going to say? Yeah, I spent a big chunk of the budget. Spent $40 and I only got four things. So I basically spent like $10 on each thing. One was $6.99. The other ones were $9.99. I'll insert some clips of my actual shopping cart. And I did really good at eliminating, like I usually do when I'm thrifting. That makes me, I know one day this week, I'm actually gonna go to a thrift store, a couple of thrift stores to see if I could find some Halloween decor or Halloween costume, cosplay type things. Follow my cosplay channel. Haven't posted anything. I have tons of videos that I can edit, but it is what it is. Yeah, I'll see y'all soon. Store, pop shelf. Yeah, the music in the air was on, but I found this new store. It's called Pop Shelf. It's looking like a Five Below, Dollar Tree type of energy. So I'm gonna go in here and see if they have any, I'm about to say Hogwarts stuff, any Halloween stuff. Oh Jesus, it's almost lunchtime. People are starting to act crazy out here at Channing Streets. So I went inside of this Pop Shelf. It's really just Five Below or Dollar Tree, Dollar General. Nothing good. And no Halloween stuff. So yeah, on to the next move. If I go that way and go over that bridge, I'll be at Pike's Nursery, you guys. What should I do? Should I go get some plants? Or should I do more Halloween shopping? Ah! Back at Michael's. Again, I didn't find anything. Wait, let me just put this on front. Only the wreath still in this Michael's Arts and Crafts, so. I don't know. Are they gonna get more things? I'm starting to feel like I should just let Michael's go until maybe like September or something. I don't know, but we're gonna keep driving around. So I'm sitting at Kohl's and I've seen a lot of people have had success with their Kohl's in their sections. I mean, in their locations, there where they live. So I'm going to go to Kohl's. I probably don't have the budget for Kohl's, but I'm sure I could maybe come back later or just get some really nice pictures. Back at it again with the front face camera. Going inside of Ross Dress for Less. Oh, that thing is some ugly. It looks like a mosquito bite, but I know it's not. My boyfriend was like, you're about to have a giant bump on your face. And I was like, well, who cares? I'm about to be on my period. And I honestly didn't see it until today. It's just right there on the cheek. Just. So So yeah, we're going inside of Ross Dress for Less because Ross be having the goods sometimes. So let's go see. After this, I'm feeling like I want to drive home. I'm going to tell Bae to meet me here because I'm hungry. And I want him to take me to lunch. Called Bae. He was awake, but he's not home. He's at his mom and dad's house. So now I'm going to, but he wasn't awake. He was awake. I don't know what I said. I'm going to hit Gabe's and then I'm going to go get me something to eat. I was going to try to do lunch with him, but since he's at his parents' house, I could do lunch by myself. And I don't know what I want. It depends on if I find anything at Gabe's, what my budget is for lunch. I'm close to my favorite taco, so maybe I could get that. Oh, I don't know. This is exactly what I want. So yeah, I'm gonna get my favorite tacos and then I'm gonna go home and I'm gonna take a shower, take a bath or something, because I just feel really dirty when I'm shopping. Like, it's so much dust in these stores, it's not even crazy. It's not even funny. But yeah, I have fun in there. I was just taking pictures. They had their skeletons, they were taking them out last time, but I was already spending so much time in there, so I thought, ooh, the air's on, so you probably can't hear me, so I'll do like a voiceover or something. Anyway, like I was saying, I just left Old Time Pottery. I'm probably gonna go get me some lunch. I really want some chorizo tacos. I'm close to my favorite place in Charlotte. What is it called? Los Altos, I think. Los Altos on Monroe Road. Best tacos that I've ever had in Charlotte. Most authentic. And I haven't had many, but the people that put me on are of Mexican descent. They're Mexican, so they know. They said like these are good. My hair's looking crazy. I need to do my hair because these mini twists are about to like lock up. And I'm sure there's like dust and everything flying from them. I'm almost like about to be in the ugly stage of getting locks again. But this is my favorite stage of locks, the starter locks, because they're so fluffy and then they just look different every day. But I won't be able to start these locks because I use product in my hair. And I told myself my next set of locks, I'm not using any product. So yeah, probably gonna do Gabe's. Actually, I think I'm gonna skip Gabe's, go get tacos, eat in the parking lot, go home, do my hair today. I wanna do like a protective style, some more twists, but with some added hair. So I'm gonna do that. Yeah, I'm not even gonna go to Gabe's. I'm done looking for the day. I only got something from one store yesterday. I did a lot more shopping when I went to Rock Hill. So I feel like I'm good. I'll probably go back out maybe Thursday. It's Tuesday, so probably Thursday. I'll give a rest on Wednesday and go out on Thursday. And then Friday, we'll have a new video. On fire. I didn't mean to spill that liquor all on my guitar. I've been drinking water. Hello, you all. It's me, Destiny. Destiny of Manifest by Destiny. It's been about a week. I haven't done any shopping. I'm here at Home Goods over near South Park. If you didn't know, all this is going down in Charlotte and the surrounding areas. I try to tag my videos, so if you're watching it, I think on the actual app or even on the, not the television, but on your computer, it'll show you that this is happening in Charlotte. But yeah, I did some little twists, y'all. No pun intended, but little twists. Rubber bands are showing. And as you can see, it's like my hair is not... I'm thinking I should have used 3 strands instead of 2. But that's the good thing, that I can actually redo them. So, you know, one at a time. But I gotta turn the air on. It's hot. Oh, it's hot. So yeah, I'm here at Home Goods. I'm going shopping. Here at Home Goods, looking for more Halloween home decor, of course. If you didn't know, my name's Destiny. Here on my channel, I discuss divination, astrology, spirituality, and my lifestyle as a witch. As of right now, like I usually say, most of my videos are lifestyle videos, so most of them are like vlogs. This is a lifestyle video of a witch named Destiny searching for Halloween decor in the month of August. This is not my angle. It's making my little moon head look more moonish. There we go. There we go. Okay. I got a little phone thing that you put your finger in and you hold it, and it's actually a vent clip as well. So yeah, it's 10:30. I usually like to get to places like at 9 o'clock, but I was chilling this morning with my plants, doing my plant mom thing. So yeah, I have to go now inside of the store. I'm gonna probably show you things from, what am I trying to say? Yeah, so then I'm probably gonna show you, talk to you when I get home. Probably not back in the car. Probably just see you when I get home, or if I decide to stop at another store. But I'm possibly grocery shopping, so yeah. I'm rambling now. 83 degrees, and I've drank most of my water. And the day just started. So yeah, I'm going in here. I'm going to take some pics, do some reels, record in landscape, and I'm ready to haul because I have stuff, all the stuff from last week that I haven't shown you. And hopefully all the stuff that I find in here. I really wanted to do this Home Goods on the south side and then hit the at home decor superstore in Midtown, is what they call it. King Street. What do I call it? I don't know what I used to call it before gentrification. Uptown, downtown, south side. I think I just call it the south side. So yeah, stay tuned, subscribe, hit the like button, and tell me your favorite part about Halloween. Yeah, let's get engagement. I'm on my way with the money. Okay. I'm inside of a parking garage. I'm at home. Downtown. Uptown. Whatever. King Street. Charlottetown Street. Kenilworth Street. Yeah, I'm shopping here. I hope y'all can hear me. It's connected to the Bluetooth, so it might not even be picking up my voice. Let me send you something. It's hot out here, and I still gotta go grocery shopping. 11:10, so I'm doing good. This is lip oil by NYX. Let me know, do you like lip oil? I wanna try the Dior lip oil. I heard that's like the epitome of all lip oils, so. I think the next time I go to New Orleans, I'm gonna get some. But lip oil is kind of like that roll-on gloss we used to use when we was kids. Stay hydrated, kids. Next time you see me, it'll just be a haul from home. Later. Hello, y'all. It's me, Destiny, of Manifest by Destiny, the girl you haven't seen in a while. I'm back.
like that angle.
Okay, anyway, as you can see, I got a new hairstyle. I had a different hairstyle inside a picture. Y'all didn't even get to see it because I wasn't recording when I had that hairstyle. I was down bad. Can't even talk. I was down bad when I had the hairstyle. But I'm up. I'm up all of a sudden. I know I got AirPods, so if I'm talking weird, that's why. But yeah. Welcome back to another Halloween 2021 shopping vlog with me, your girl Destiny. I got this Verse Silk Slip Tinted Lip Oil because you know I really like lip oil. Wanted to get some tinted. It's in the color Ruby. Got it from Target. Under $10. Oh, good. What you see? Whew, okay. It is very pigmented. My lips aren't as pink as they used to be, you know? So, something that shows up. I'm still pink in the middle, but you know. I think I naturally have dark lips. Oh, my mustache is definitely still there. The genetics, I tell you. So, we're at Dollar Tree. I'm going to insert the clip. I'm actually pulled up straight to the front of the door. Also, I'm not like a disclaimer type of person, but if you have issues with someone not speaking King's proper American English on this channel, says she, or bruh, or whatever you refer to yourself as to, get over it. You can still say subscribe, of course, because I like subscribers, and you can still watch because why not? But just get over it because, you know, everybody's not raised the same, or everybody, like, obviously I went all the way up to graduate school, so I know a little some. Like Young Miami said, it's some, y'all very much be trying to find something, very much something. No. I'm just so happy to be back. I look good, honey. I look great. Oh, I said my whole motto. That's my new motto. Feeling good. Feeling great. I look good. Don't hate. We're at the Dollar Tree. We're here because my boyfriend said, have you tried the Dollar Tree for your Halloween shopping? And no, I haven't. I haven't, babe. So thanks for looking out for me. Thanks for looking out for the people. Yeah, if y'all, I left like basically, I don't have baby hairs. It looks like I left all my edges out. And they're curling up because it's hot out here. I really don't know what I'm doing. But I tried knotless. Some of them are knotless. Some of them aren't. Some of them got done over. Some of them got the ends of my hair, real hair, clipped out of them. It's just... And now I'm just done with it. I curled the ends. Some of them had blue little rods. Some of them had pink rods. I used regular foaming lotion by Dr. Bronner's, I think, because I didn't want to go to the store. But for sure that Shine and Jam, or I found some Shine and Jam braiders. This is just like a hair talk break for the girls that are here for the hair. Girls and boys and them, all y'all that are here for the hair. This is... yeah, that Shine and Jam, but they have it for braiders. So basically it's all through my hair because I put it on my hand. And this time I actually fed in. I've never fed in. You can see how some places it's like you can see some braids really came out like very nicely though. So this is my first time. I'm going to try them again for my birthday, Scorpio gang. And yeah, do it like a Shelby day. I'm going to do it in my favorite color. I think it's color number 6. It'll match my eyes. And yeah. I'm probably gonna do them bigger. Hopefully my hair is probably not gonna grow that much in the next 2 months, but who knows. I want to do them bigger. I have 19 braids. I want it like a good 13 braids is what I want. So yeah, we're heading into Dollar Tree. Stay tuned. That was a 4-minute intro. Shout out to the real ones that are still here. It's my protection charm for my car. Oh yeah, and I have a mask. Gotta put my mask on. I have this one, and I have this one. I think I'm gonna put this on and put this on top of it, but I don't know, I might not be able to breathe, so. I'm just gonna put this one on because, no, I'm gonna put this one on. People always saying, I can't breathe. Child, you can breathe. That's what people say. To each his own though. Who are you to tell somebody if they can breathe? You know? But yeah, it has permanent the lip bar, the red lip gloss or lip matte print is on there. I tried this new deodorant from Walmart and it leaves like a stain. It even got on my shirt. So today I'm going to get like a crystal, one of those crystal things. So the one I was using was natural, but it just is too chalky. It's probably like a gym deodorant. So, oh my God, a bee almost went into the door. He was trying so hard. He almost got like smashed in the crack of the door. Okay. Whew, now I have to go past him. I'm talking a lot. I gotta go. Stay tuned. See what's happening here, and there's a lot more shit. I don't know. I think I want one of those cups, but I don't know. I think the cups aren't glass, so I don't need it. I had one that was glass, but it got chipped last year. Yeah, plastic. Halloween, happy hunting. These are good because you can make DIY art. Like I could color her in, color in the cat, frame it, boom. Place to check is also in the glassware section in Dollar Tree because they just have nice things, and you see they have those. Like, look at this, not Halloween themed, but it has the drinks on it. If you reach for me, which tip, this is a good place to come get Himalayan pink salt for your spell.
That's right, Saturday's power.
Okay. I don't know. Did I put the noise? I don't know if the noise cancellation's on or not. I'm about to take these little things out of my ear. But yeah, I got the goods from, I'll say Walmart. Isn't it like away? Oh, because I turned the Bluetooth off. I don't know. But I'm headed to go grocery shopping now. So I was gonna make this like a new video, but I think this is just gonna be added to the shopping that I did like a month ago. So just enjoy the footage from a month ago. I'll probably edit it a little bit more, but you'll see what was out there, maybe what's still out there, and then now you can see what's new at Dollar Tree. I got hand and hair syndrome. I can't stop touching, can't stop seeing the imperfections. I'm just so happy to be done. Ooh, see? I'm happy I didn't drive away right away, because I would have been over there in that mess. But, this girl almost attacked my head talking about some, did you do those? How much do you charge? I was like, whoa, sis, I don't do people's hair. Like, straight like that. I should have said, whoa, you're disrespecting my boundaries. Like, it was almost like that. Like, you know, when you're learning a demonstration or training at work and they have to say something so you know. I was like, whoa, sister, you're disrespecting my boundaries. This is all the Halloween shop I'm going to do today, unless there's some, like, in the grocery store, which I highly doubt it. I'm, like, addicted to putting this stuff on my lips. It feels so good, you know? When I get home, I'm probably going to shave my mustache. You know, have you like stared at yourself long enough, you're like, dang, I'm ugly. And then sometimes, like, if you stare at yourself long enough, you're like, wow, whoever created this being is like psychotic, because who would make something so beautiful? So it's haul time. Let's take a look around my room to see the items that I already started decorating with. That skull planter with the roses, I got two of those from At Home. This black jack-o'-lantern I got from TJ Maxx. Or Marshall's, I think it was. I found this really cool cauldron plant stand at Home Goods. And I really like it because it's nice and slender. You know, it's a tripod, three legs. So it saves space here in the garden. My favorite find was this Hogwarts crest that I found. I think Books a Million. You know, I'm Team Slytherin. Comment below, which team, which house are you? I found this Who Needs Halloween? I'm a Witch All Year. I cannot remember for the life of me which store I found this in. And the Trick or Treat Yourself. I want to say I got this from Ross or Marshall's. It's been a month since I've got some of these items, so if you can tell by the sticker, you'll be able to figure it out. But Home Goods, Marshall's, TJ Maxx. Beginning the haul, here is one of the blankets that I got. It's upside down. Yeah, this was the blanket that I got it from Marshall's, and it's very soft, and I love it because, like I said, I think I said it like a couple videos ago or a video ago something, said I wanted a dark blanket. All the blankets were like light colored or orange, but this one's cute. I got that from TJ Maxx. Also, before I go any further, I noticed that I tell you exactly what lip product I'm using every time I put it on. Today, I got my mustache off, but today I'm using the e.l.f. Mint Melt Lip Plumping Gloss in Chocolate Chip, and I can't remember. I think it was Peyton Marie Charles who talked about this. Somebody talked about this on their channel, and I couldn't find the chocolate chip, but I got it in like mint chocolate, which is more of like a salmon pink natural lip color. This one is like brown. I'll show you. And yeah, see, it kind of cancels. It looks orange. It just cancels out the pinkness. So you could use this with a dark lip liner or a black or red, any color. But I think this would look really good with like brown on the outside. Before I show you, I kind of inserted all of the things that I've already put up in my room, like decorated with. So I'll go through and do a little voiceover explaining what those things are, where I got them from. Yeah, I did do a book haul from Five Below, so I'm going to insert this into this Halloween decor shop with me vlog, because why not? The first book I got is The Astrology Dictionary, Cosmic Knowledge from A to Z, and it is by, meet the author, so it doesn't say their names. It's by Donna Woodwell. Oh, it does say. It's by Donna Wilbur. And this literally is a dictionary. It tells you, like, you could flip it open. Fourth house, noun, sun, or when the sun is in the fourth house, okay. Tells you, like, the noun Gemini, noun moon sign, noun lunation cycle, Sagittarius, Saturn, Saturn return, royal stars, Regulus. Regulus marks the heart of the lion in the constellation of Leo. Planetary sect. In traditional astrology, planets are divided into two teams, known as sects, like, you know, different groups, basically. These teams are led by the sun and the moon. The planets Jupiter and Saturn are on the sun's team. I didn't know this. Did I know this? I don't know. Venus and Mars are on the moon's team, and Mercury can join either sect. When I hear that, that makes me think, like, divided into two, like, polar opposites, masculine, feminine, yin-yang. That's the energy it's giving. I can understand Mercury because I think that's one of the ambiguous gods or planets. So, yeah, of course, it was $5, and I think this is just something nice to have. I don't know. Whenever I buy a book, I always think about passing it down. This noise control. I saw this TikTok or reel of this girl in New York who she said she was being followed when she had the noise cancellation on. And I'm inside of my house. I should feel very safe and secure, but I can't hear anything. I can hear something like a car, but it's like one of those loud old school cars. I got the Speedy Yoga. Stretch yourself, not your schedule. 50 peaceful poses to balance your busy life. And this is like one of those books, like in the style like a kid's book, you know, really thick. Open it up, it gives you, you can see the colors kind of, gives you different asanas, different workouts, different sequences. Next, I got the complete guide to natural vitamins from food and, that's it. Next, I got the complete guide to natural vitamins from Food and Supplements by Lizzie Striet. And she's some type of Dr. MS, RD, and LD. So she knows what she's talking about, I guess. Yeah, it's just, it's supposed to be easy ways to get your nutrients with your actual diet. So you don't have to take in so much supplements. And then it also tells you about, like, vitamin B6, the protein creator. How you can use it in supplements, common food sources, B3. Vitamins, minerals, and you. Kind of how you can put it all together, magnesium. Okay, so that's how it glows. Fluoride, sulfur, oh, I love sulfur. One of my favorite elements, crystals, I don't know. Next, I got the unofficial amazing activities for Harry Potter fans. Because of course I'm a Harry Potter fan. You saw the sign. Seems Slytherin. So yeah, this is puzzles and games for hours of entertainment. And I thought this would be fun just to do. Has all types of word mazes and crossword puzzles to connect the dots. This is like my favorite one. Wait, I saw the Sudoku. That's like mathematical. I don't know how mathematical because I've never tried one. But I want to get into those next. That's a one pot cooking, quick and easy dishes to make in your skillet, sheet pan, Dutch oven, slow cooker, and more. So this is like one pot meals. And anybody who eats food basically likes one pot meals. Fettuccine with vegetable marinara sauce. Pan roasted pike with buttery breadcrumbs. Did you say pike? I mean, I actually cook. Whoa, that thing, did y'all see that? That thing came around and hit me in the eye. Actually, from the five and below. I got the who do you think you are? Find out about yourself in 20 psychological tests. And if you know, I'm into mental health, psychology, psychotherapy, all those things. So yeah, I got this and I thought this would be fun. I like, when you see the outside, how could you not want to go to the book? Super colorful, yellow, makes you happy. Has a glossary, fluid intelligence, empathy, extrovert, impulsiveness, personality trait. Tells you all about those cool things, zodiac signs. So, yeah. All of those things matter. Neophilia describes
when a person loves new things and experiences, finding them is exciting and fulfilling. For example, a neophile would probably want to hang out at new places rather than always doing the same thing. So I'm not a neophile. I might be a neo. Uh-oh. Sorry, the camera's dying. Or the phone's dying. A neophobe describes when a person dislikes or is fearful of new things and experiences, finding them uncomfortable or even threatening. A neophobe would probably much rather hang out in the same place with the same people, not risk trying something different. I mean, I like different things. I can't remember. I'm an ISTP. It's on my Pinterest. I think I'm an ISTP. But it talks about how to measure your personality, a brief history of personality, which zodiac sign should you be. Now let's look at the stars. Never mind your actual zodiac sign. At heart, are you water, earth, air, or fire personality? Oh, that's so cool. Do y'all want to do that? Let's do this right now. You know what? I'll just bring this out and do this in a separate video because it's gonna get a little intense. But yeah, those are all the books that I got. I got 5 books from Five and Below. I want to say I got another one, but who knows where it's at? From Amazon associate here. So if you shop with your girl, I get a little bit of that commission. Favorite beauties, Fantastic Beauties, adult coloring book. Here's a sample on the back of just some of the images that are in here. And I'll show you kind of one of the sample pages. Look at this. Boom. And I just bought the brown skin, like skin tone colored color pills for that. I also got some more arts and crafts things, but that's for my Dollar Tree haul. So just stay tuned for that. This is 12 minutes. This video is going to be really long. I went to Barnes & Noble's and I got 2 books. I got Amari and the Knight Brothers by B.B. Alston. So I'll be reading this. This is about, what is this about? Oh yeah, a girl and her brothers. And I think she's trying to get back with them or something. And she discovers magic. And this is Blood Like Magic. Lizelle Sanberry. To save my family's magic, I must destroy my first love. I never wanted to be a killer. That doesn't get me flagged on here. But I am a Thomas witch. We suffer and we survive. Ooh, hit my scorpion. But I felt that right here, sis. I felt that. This one was $19.99. This one was $17.99. So drop a stack of books, the emoji below, if you'd like to see me do a book review. I have all these books. I read them. I don't do book reviews. So I just forget. But I'm gonna try to do a Instagram post about these maybe together and an actual YouTube video about them together. So I'm gonna try to read these like in the next 2 weeks. I'm gonna try to do one a week, and then next week or in the next 2 weeks you will see me do a book review. The artwork is like so beautiful. That's what called me in. Now we're going to Dollar Tree. This isn't from Dollar Tree. This is from Littles, whatever it's called. The Aldi's, the like more upscale Aldi's, y'all gotta go there because that place is cool. I've never had a like disposable lighter like this that had a cap on it. But yeah, I've been like stocking up on just goods for the home because you never know. I'm understanding that. So now I bought some of these. I don't even know how that entered into this chat room, but yeah. Dollar Tree. Anyway, I got these colored pencils. Did I get this from Dollar Tree? I think I got this from, I don't know, but it has mahogany, aqua green, light brown, tan brown, violet, light blue, jade green, yellow green. Jade green is one of my favorite colored pencils, but look at that. So I have this to go with that Amazon coloring book that I just got. Terrarium planter. I think I want to do something like spooky, like, so I'm gonna do a spooky DIY with some air plants with this. Okay, I think the camera shut off because it was dying, but my actual ring light has a, let's see how you gonna fix this. An actual ring light. Look at that. Look at that terrarium. Up there. Right there. Hi, Mrs. Skeleton. Or Mrs. Skeleton. Ms. Skeleton, excuse me. She's a single lady. She ain't no wife, so talk to her nice. More lighters from Littles. And then when I was in the Dollar Tree, I think I showed you the home decor, but I found these really cute, stylish, like vases. Vase, says on the bottom. Yeah, I got them in black. And if you didn't know, I don't know if I told y'all, I'm decorating my bathroom in Halloween decor. So I think I might take that into my bathroom and get like a single black rose, something that looks nice and fresh, or get a bouquet of those black roses that stay alive for a while and put it in that. I got this green one just to put in here to give more Slytherin vibes, even though it's not like dark Slytherin green. I feel like green's my favorite color. Black, green, and highlighter yellow, and gold. I like gold too. Got another one. I'm probably gonna put one in this room. I think it's black. It looks like it's black. And I'm gonna use this to put like jewelry when I take it off in the bathroom. I did drop a witchy tip as I was shopping. Himalayan sea salt. Or pink Himalayan. Blah, 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 blah. That's all, folks. Himalayan pink sea salt. Himalayan pink sea salt. Why? Yeah, why does it not say sea salt? Himalayan pink salt. Why do I think it's supposed to say C? I don't know, but of course, this is great for when you're doing your work. Let's get to the Halloween theme thing. Thing. I know I've been talking for way too long. I found this really cute Halloween galvanized plaque. And it is from the Crafter Square. I really did like the Crafter Square collection from the Dollar Tree. It was more gothic chic, you know, my style, more gothic glam. I feel like the Dollar Tree has really good options when it's not like covered in glitter or like this doesn't look that bad. And this is just gonna look really nice hanging up on my wall. I don't know. Next, I got this sign, not really Halloween themed, but it does match my decor. You did not wake up to be mediocre. Isn't that cute? And it's just like a little thing that you can put up on the wall. Hand sanitizer, because the world we live in. So this is really the most Halloween-ish thing that I got from the Dollar Tree. I got tons of Halloween cards. I got 16 and they have glitter all over them, but I'm going to do a fun DIY with these cards, so I thought 4x4 would be good for them. I'll just kind of show them. Oh, well, you can't see them because it's front facing, but I think I showed you when I picked them out. But I got for an amazing girl. This little witch has lost her way. Help her back and save the day. Hope your Halloween is nothing but fun from beginning to end. And this is the expressions from Hallmark. So some of these were a dollar. I think that was probably a dollar, and then some of them were 50 cents. It's Halloween, do whatever floats your broomstick. And with this, I'm probably gonna fill her in so she's like my skin tone, so she could be me, you know, in my bathroom. So yeah, I got those 16 Halloween cards. Stay tuned for that DIY. Drops glitter. So I want to thank, I'm gonna put my other AirPod in. I feel I'm a little less anxious right now, so I can put it in. I want to thank you all for watching this video. I know it's been pretty long. This video, I tried to edit it and speed things up, but not too fast that it was blurry. So I hope it's not too long. If it is too long, who cares? I know that you all really love me and you support my channel, and are my hands ashy? No, you support my channel. So thanks for watching the entire video. Thanks for making it to the end. You are a superstar. You're doing a good job. You're doing a good job. You're doing a good job. That's my song. I can't wait to do a reel to that. But yeah, until next time, it's me, Destiny, of Manifest by Destiny. Don't forget, I do link most of the things that I show in my videos that I'm using or that I'm talking about down in the description box. Also, please shop my Amazon storefront. Until next time, bye.
Stimulate my mind with some metaphysical, vibrating conversation.